Chapter 8, Hypodermic Syringe Measurement. Syringe volume sizes commonly used in medical practice are half of the milliliter, 1 milliliter, 3 milliliter, 5 milliliter, 10 milliliter, 20 milliliter, and 60 milliliter syringe, which you have right now on the screen in the chart. Usually, the capacity from 0.5 milliliter to 3 milliliter syringe we call small capacity syringes, and starting from 5 milliliter and up, there will be the larger capacity syringes. We need to go over those syringes and take a look at their calibration and how to calculate and shade dosages in those syringes. The structure of each syringe as follows. So first of all, we have to add a needle, and usually it's attached to the tip of the syringe. The container where we are placing the medication we call bottle. Also, we use the plunger to push out the medication. The volume markings or calibration on the syringe, usually we use smaller and larger markers to show larger units and smaller units. This syringe is calibrated in milliliters. You want to take a larger calibration is milliliters. If you want to take a look at that cc, this is all their notation for milliliter. Right now it's not used, so make sure if you see still cc, it's a milliliter. So therefore this syringe is 12 milliliter capacity. We also have the plunger tip, which will determine the dosage which we are injecting in the client, and plunge. This is there for the fingers that will hold against the plunger. Let's talk about small capacity 3 milliliter syringe, because it is the most commonly used syringe. This syringe is calibrated using the metric unit milliliter. As you can see on the image on the right, there are longer calibrations and shorter calibrations. So longer calibrations indicate half of the milliliter. So you see that maximum capacity is 3 milliliters. Then if we will take a closer look at the shorter calibration, that each half of the milliliter has 5 units here, which means that we have a 1/10 milliliter of calibration. So example, we want to indicate the following amount of medication on the syringe. Let's talk about a 0.1 milliliter. 0.1 milliliter is a first line after the long. So this one is 0.1 milliliter. B, 0.6 milliliter, we understand that the calibration in 1/10 milliliter, so we will count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So we will here show 0.6 milliliters. And C, 1.9 milliliter, so this is 1 milliliter, 1.5. We can continue counting 1 and 6, 1 and 7, 1 and 8, 1 and 9, and that will be 1.9 milliliters. Reading a scale on 3 milliliter syringe. Question: what is the volume of medication in this syringe? In order to answer, we need to count how many full length larger calibrations are here, and we can observe that this is 1 milliliter. So the answer here will be, since we know this is a 3 milliliter syringe, the calibration is in the 10th, so therefore the correct answer will be 1.2 milliliter, not as it is stated in the answer. So very easy to misread the calibration. Another commonly used syringe for small dosages is tuberculin syringes. The common volumes for them is 1 milliliter to 0.5 milliliters, mostly used in pediatric care. It's used to administer the high-sensitive medication like heparin for adults and in pediatric vaccines. Usually the calibration of those syringes is in the hundreds, and we want to take a look at that scale. So please take a look at the larger calibrations. So they usually label it by 0.1, 0.2, 0.3, 0.4, 0.5, so total capacity is 0.5 milliliter. And each of larger calibration is divided into 10 smaller ones. So here is the correct way to calculate the size of the increment. You usually need to read first the closest sign calibrations. So the value 0.2 and 0.1 are the closest, and we will need to divide that by the number of intervals between them. So since the difference is 0.1 divided by 10 intervals, the answer is 0.01 milliliter. That's what we need to remember. Each 10 calibration mark numbered is printed on the syringe, as we already observed. Reading a scale on tuberculin syringe. Question: what is the volume of medication in the syringe? Let's take a look how to read this syringe. So we take a look at 0.1, it's right here, then we have 0.2, and after that we are counting 4 additional units, and that actually brings us 0.24 hundredths of milliliters. Syringe of large capacity, 5 milliliter and 10 milliliter syringe. To calculate increments, subtract 2 consecutive labeled units, for example 2 milliliters minus 1 milliliter, and divide by the number of intervals between them. So we will subtract 2 minus 1, 1, and divide it by 5, that gives us 0.2. Please notice that increment for 5 milliliter and 10 milliliter syringe is larger, since this is already the large capacity syringe and this is 0.2 milliliters. Reading the scale on 10 milliliter syringe, question: what is the volume of the medication in this syringe? At this point, we have the example of 5 milliliters only, since this is exactly the straightforward answer. But we also will take a look at this. Let's try to read also this volume, and keep in mind that this is between 3 and 4, so we realize that the volume will be 3 point, and make sure that each unit here represents 2/10 of the milliliters, so therefore we should count 3 times 2/10, that will be 3.6 milliliters. Keep in mind, this is not 3 and 3/10 of the milliliters. This reading will be incorrect.